like I'm staring into my soul. How do you get it to stay up like that? And also your hair. Oh, hey, it's Craig Ferguson, host of the show.
What the hell's going on?
No, I'm just here with my cousin.
What's your name?
Alex.
Where are you from?
Boston.
I didn't know you had a cousin from Boston.
Yeah, I do now.
How are you related? On what side?
My mom.
What are you in town for, Alex? Why are you here?
I've been living here for about a year now.
Then you're not from Boston anymore, son. I didn't know he could shrug. I didn't know you could shrug. Shrug again. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Hey, let's all shrug. The side down, shrug, man. Shrug like your cousin.
Grab my shoulders and move them, man. Thanks. Thanks.
Whoa, have you been working out?
Yeah, you like my guns?
Yeah. Well, the usual well-planned, thought-out, pristine comedy show this evening for you, ladies and gentlemen. Join us after the commercial, so I don't.
Show with Craig Ferguson, sponsored by Applebee's new unbelievably great tasting and under 550 calorie entrees. Taste and believe. See you tomorrow. Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
I'd like to thank the Academy for including me in the Oscar nominations today. I know what you're thinking. Craig, you weren't included in the Oscar nominations. Correct. But it is, in fact... Were you included? Did you get any Oscar nominations?
No, hell no.
No. There's no Oscars for us here. We're Cinderella working here. That's us. We clean the basement while the rest of the Hollywood has a good time. It's a great day for America, everybody. It is, of course, a big day. It's a very big day. Hollywood is a very big day. The Oscar nominations were announced this morning at 5:30 a.m. I was up there. I was up anyway. I got a two-year-old in the house. I got a two-year-old kid in the house. I'm up. I'm watching Yo Gabba Gabba for the 580th time. Hello, friends. Shut up, DJ Lance. Anyway, here's where you're wrong when you were going, ha-ha, Craig, you weren't nominated for an Oscar, because the movie Brave was nominated in the Best Animated Feature, and I did a voice in that movie, so hurrah! Yeah. Now, Hurrah! Now, a couple of years ago, How to Train Your Dragon was nominated, and I did a voice in that too. I am sensing a pattern. Accolades are only given to my work in if I don't show my face in it. Welcome to the Emmy-winning special of The Late Late Show. Now, of course, I'm very proud of the movie Brave. It's a great film, and I want it to win, but we're up against Frank and Weenie. I'm up against a weenie again. Is it worth getting beaten by a weenie just to... The movie that got the most nominations this morning was Lincoln. It is, in fact, the first time in history that Hollywood has ever supported a Republican. Lincoln... Hey, I know you oohed me there, but let's be honest, that's true! Lincoln got 12 nominations, Life of Pi got 11, and Ghost Rider 2, Spirit of Vengeance got zip. Nothing. Nothing at all. It is an outrage. Nicolas Cage played the motorcycle riding skeleton on fire. Let's see Daniel Day-Lewis doing that. You can't! There's only three actors in Hollywood that can convincingly. There's only three actors in Hollywood that can. Welcome to the Emmy winning! There's only three actors in Hollywood that can convincingly play a skeleton. There is Jeff Peterson, of course. There is Nicolas Cage in Ghost Rider and Ghost Rider 2, Spirit of Vengeance. And there's Keira Knightley in anything that she does. Oh, that's right. That's right. Ooh, me. I'm the one that hasn't eaten. To be honest, I haven't seen the movie Lincoln, but I know a lot of... Well, I'm up early watching Yo Gabba Gabba all the time. So I know a lot of people who've seen Lincoln, and some of them stayed awake through the whole thing, and they say that Daniel Day-Lewis... They say Daniel Day-Lewis is terrific. You know who was originally supposed to play Lincoln was Liam Neeson, but he had to drop out. I bet Liam Neeson would have been fantastic as Abraham Lincoln. What would that have sounded like, Jeff?
Quickly, Mary Todd, there's not much time. Touch my balls.
Wait. Did you just say, touch my balls?
I don't know what the hell that was.
No, man. Lincoln never said that.
I don't know who you are, but I will find you, and I will free you.
Ooh, man. Ooh, I don't know. Do you know who's up against Daniel Day-Lewis for Daniel Day-Lewis? Daniel Day-Lewis. That's the Irish way they've seen it. Daniel Day-Lewis. But they... Bradley Cooper is... Now, I like Bradley Cooper. I am pulling for Bradley Cooper. I also hope he wins the Oscar. He was here. He's a very nice guy. We was here recently.
Lovely man.
What a great guy. And I'm not gay, but, you know, I probably would. But, you know, I'd make out with him and see what happened. Anyway, he was robbed for Hangover and Hangover 2 and Midnight Meat Train, which was his first movie. That's true. It's a real movie, Midnight Meat Train. And I watched it. I was very disappointed. It's an actual movie. One of the big upsets was Best Director category. Everyone assumed Catherine Bigelow would be nominated. She directed Zero Dark Thirty, a very intense, amazing movie. But no women were nominated at all. The directing category looks like Obama's cabinet. Aha! Am I right, people who'd rather be watching The Daily Show? Well, it's over now, and you still can't sleep. And here I am. Waiting for you. You know who else who wasn't nominated was that beautiful girl from Django Unchained. What's her name again? Leonardo DiCaprio. And... Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm the one who's as pretty as a girl. Remember, actors, please, don't feel bad if you weren't nominated. It just means that you suck. Winning an Oscar... Winning an Oscar can change an actor's life. It guarantees you are remembered forever and you're a star until you die, like Melissa Leo. That's my point! Do you know the composer John Williams was nominated for his Lincoln score? This is his 48th nomination. Two more nominations, he gets a free Subway sandwich. I wonder if John Williams... John Williams even pretends to care at this point. He's like, oh, wow, another Oscar nomination. I'm so excited. Maybe I'll get to meet Melissa Leo. Like, John Williams can do anything and they'll give him an Oscar. He's like, he goes up and goes, I've got a new theme for this music. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Oh, it's amazing! John, that's just shaving a haircut. No, 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 it's John Williams shaving a haircut. Listen. Dun, 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 dun.
Yeah. Midnight meat train.
Yeah. Do you follow the Oscars then? Were you disappointed or are you excited?
No, it's going to be great, man. Lots of great movies.
You know, Seth MacFarlane is hosting it this year, so I have high hopes. I think Seth is an intelligent, clever, talented performer. So, that'll be a change. No, no, no. No, Billy did it last year. Billy Crystal did it last year. He's great. Billy Crystal is great. And then the year before, there was that twink and Anne Hathaway did it.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, man. Remember that? What was that, like five and a half hours, 6 hours, 4.5 days, a week? I went on. It was forever it went on.
Yeah, no, I was stoned through most of that.
What do you mean?
You know what I mean.
Drugs?
Yeah.
No, I was asking if you had any drugs.
No, yeah, I'll see you after the show.
No, I'll come over now.
Come on.
Go to the commercial break.
Right.
You're watching The Late Late Show, nominated for 10 Academy Awards, including Best Way to Kill an Hour While Stoned Off Your Ass.
Tonight, Jeff's cousin is here from Boston, right, Jeff?
Yeah,
Jeff's cousin Alex. Did you guys grew up together, right?
Yeah, we've known each other for years.
What does Alex do for a living?
He's a contractor.
A contractor?
Yeah, hell yeah.
All right, what kind of contracting does he do then?
Yeah, he builds adobe huts. And
adobe
stuff.
Hut? Sure. You don't want to be building an adobe hut in Boston. It rains in Boston. There are drunk people who can come over and knock your hut over.
Well, that's part of the fun.
Wait. Did I just hear an ooh there like there aren't drunk people in Boston? Because, wait a minute, I don't know. I know Boston well. I like Boston. I've got people in Boston. I went to Boston, 5, 6 years in a row. I did the Boston 4th of July. I noticed some drunk people when I was in Boston. Maybe it's just the people I was hanging out with. The cops.
Yeah.
You know when I was doing, you remember I did that 4th of July thing and what, the clamshell in Boston at the 4th of July, I did that. And for in order to get there, such a big crowd, the cops give you, Boston cops, they give you a motorcycle escort all the way to the thing. It's fantastic, makes you feel like the president. You just shrugged at that? You shrugged at the idea of me having a motorcycle escort. Now you're just, what, laughing? Laughing and shrugging. Jerk. Anyway, what time is it, Jeffrey Pearson?
It's tweet mail time. Time to take advice from a man who the Boston Herald calls the Melissa Leo of late night television.
Play the jingle!
Here come the players.
So don't despair.
Use your fingers, use your toes, use your
boobies.
I've got those.
Emails and tweets. Emails and tweets.
Emails and tweets.
The hell was that?
I think you've gone too far.
Yeah, I've gone. I clearly have gone. I don't even remember making that, though. That's the problem. I think that was using my image on computers. All right, tweets and emails time. Oh, my gosh, really? Is that it? 1 minute, 40 seconds to do them all? Okay. Ready? We'll do a speed read. You ready?
All right, let's do it.
Okay, you ready? Do Liam Neeson to get me in the mood.
Quickly, there's no time.
There's read no time. Quickly, all right, okay. Hey, this is from Jackie in Mason City, Iowa. Says, Jackie, dear Craig and Jeff, why do you keep ripping up emails that have mother-in-law in them? This is from Rachel in Boise, Idaho. You ever been to Boise, Idaho? Dear Craig, how much does Secretariat's butt actor get paid? I don't even know what you're talking about. What are they talking about? Exactly. This is from Marlene in Richardson, Texas, who says, dear Craig and Jeff, do lesbian row seats cost more than other seats when attending your show? Yes, double the price. This is from... They're free, the seats here. No one's going to pay for this.
Crikey.
You mean if I come to Hollywood, I can come here and sit here for free? Yeah. This is from Carl in Elizabeth, New Jersey. You ever been there?
Beautiful, beautiful place.
Elizabeth, New Jersey?
Sure, yeah.
Dear Craig and Jeff, I was just wondering if Liam Neeson or Jason Statham have ever been in Downton Abbey. Do you know? Let's try it then. Okay, I'll be Jason Statham, you be Liam Neeson. It's Downton Abbey. You ready?
All right, yes.
All right. You start.
I say, good sir. Quickly.
If you come over here to Downton Abbey, I'll
Tootsie Fruits
cut you up.
How dare you, good sir?
I bid you adieu.
You know what? We raced through those emails. I think we all got a little bit adrenal. I think it's a little bit of quiet time before the commercial break.
Oh, yeah.
A little bit. Are you at home to join us? Why don't you unbuckle your pants? Let's have a little, little quiet time. Funny comedian. He's at the Great Venetian Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas, February the 1st and 2nd, and then the 22nd and 23rd. He also stars in Last Man Standing, which airs Friday nights on ABC. Take a look at this. Tim Allen, everybody, Tim Allen. Lovely to see you again.
Good to see you.
You look great. I like this jacket. You're making money, then.
It's not mine.
Wow. That's fantastic. No, it's like one of them.
Really, it really is. I'm taping Hollywood, you know, the other CBS Radford, which is on the other side of the hill. If you're not from here, it's
meaningless.
On the other side of the hill.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Even if you are from here, or even if you're not from here, it's still on the other side of the hill. Anyway, we rehearsed today, and they
give you this jacket?
Well, give. You know this business.
See how the ratings are, and then if you can keep, maybe you can keep the jacket.
It's
a nice jacket, though. It's like one of those lazy boys, you know, that you get with a...
No, Craig, it's not. No, that's a chair. No. It had nothing to do with that.
It's like a chair. Like
it's not!
If I had money, I would get a chair that was covered in a fabric like that. That's all I'm saying.
Okay, got that.
Yeah.
You moved. This used to be in a basement. Now you got a real studio.
Well, I wouldn't go as far as to say it's a real studio, this is the studio that was built for Pat Sajak's late night show.
That's it. Yeah. It's glad that you bring that up.
Yeah, I know.
And also, was Politically Incorrect was here, right?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that was here. Because that was, were you on that show?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I was on that show a couple of times. Bill Maher.
Bill Maher. That's when he was a little softer. Bill was a little quieter guy.
Yeah, he was quieter then. Now he's out of control.
I don't know.
He was never that soft, Bill. No.
Yeah, well, always... You know what I mean? It was. He was a little more balanced. Not him personally, because he's still.
No, he's always been unbalanced. Yeah, he can say, but now he's on cable, he can say what you like. You can't say what you like on network television.
You can think about it.
You can think about it, but you start expressing your opinion, you're... Ay, caramba!
Whoa! What he meant, I said that during the... How did that happen? What just happened?
I don't know. I just wanted to cuss. That's why I led us into it. Yeah.
I said that on Santa Claus 2. I did that in front of the children. I dressed as Santa Claus. It's a long time ago. So
yeah.
I was a different guy. And the Disney people told the children, I said, Lingonberry.
Is that a real word?
It's a Swedish word, means lunch. Santa.
Santa wants lunch. Swedish.
Oh, I got so mad at children. I mean, what was I thinking? I hate children.
No, come on, you don't. He doesn't mean it.
I don't like mine that much.
No, come on.
I haven't
met your kids, but I'm sure they're great. My kids, yours are fantastic, though.
They're little.
I've got a little one, right? You got a little one?
I have a little 3.5-year-old.
You see a lot of Yo Gabba Gabba right now?
No, we don't let them watch TV.
What? You're crazy?
We read books.
I guess that's what you do in Al-Qaeda.
Wow! It could be. Actually, we're Taliban. We're a little left of that.
I don't know what that is. Yeah.
I don't know. Taliban would be a little left of that, wouldn't it?
I don't know, man. I don't know enough about it. I know that none of it's good for us. None of it.
No, they don't like this. They like this show.
Really?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, I like Ferguson. Very funny.
They love it. Well, what's it? Al Gore has made it possible now for Al Jazeera. They moved in, didn't
they? That's right. They bought Current TV. Yeah.
Right.
I don't think Al Jazeera or anything to do with the Taliban, though.
Well, it's. I make that adjustment for comedy purposes.
I see.
Like the famous Otto and George says, I exaggerate to clarify.
I see.
All right. This is kind of that moment of silence that you had.
Yeah, no. Oh, a quiet time.
Which is one of the better parts of the show.
You want to do one?
It's very difficult for me to shut up.
Come on. Let's try it. Let's try one quiet time.
I don't like this guy, though. Come on.
Come on. Satnam.
Really? Very hard for me.
Yeah.
Very, very hard.
All right, that's enough. I don't want to make you uncomfortable.
I actually got a backache from that.
Really?
I'm not.
No, I tell you, your back is from motorcycles. You're still riding motorcycles, aren't you?
I don't know what you just said.
Yes, you do.
No, you said still ride motorcycles?
Yeah, still riding motorcycles. You continue to ride motorcycles in the face of all the evidence.
You've been here long enough. Cut the accent, all right? You're from here. It's not really helping with the ratings. Just cut it.
He was riding the motorcycles.
Right. Yeah.
I seen you riding the motorcycles. You're riding it around.
I tried a hybrid. Not an electric thing. I tried to get it's called a Daviel. It's a Ducati, kind of half sport bike, half cruiser.
And you wear a sundress on it or something?
How do you say that? A little off the shoulder thing,
okay.
A nice Dolly Parton hat. Yes, as a matter of fact, they do. That's all of us motorcycle guys trying to get a little softer, Craig.
A Dolly Parton hat? I never even heard of a Dolly Parton hat.
I don't know what that meant.
Yeah.
I didn't want to go to the boobs right away. That seemed cheap. So I meant, what's it, a Mini Pearl.
A Mini Pearl hat.
Wait a minute, I have one.
You have a hat with
it? No, I got a tag.
Oh, all right, yeah. Yours now, buddy.
AB Sue You.
It's all right. Was that the Home Improvement was on ABC, wasn't it?
Yes.
Oh, that was a good show. That show.
Yeah, I just rebooted Three Girls instead of Three Boys. You saw a trailer with Al.
It's like everybody's the same. It's the same. It's not the same show.
Just try to spit it out. It's not the same.
Right.
It's not the same at all. There's about 300 people watching. Before we could tell the. It's not the same venue anymore. There's so many things on TV. People.
I know. It's totally different.
It's everything.
Yeah,
you have another season now. The cable season.
That's a season? They have a cable season?
Slow down for a second.
I don't understand your accent.
Oh. This, when you get to this part of the season, I don't know when this airs. God knows this is probably airing on Mars sometime, right? Because you tape out of sequence, you say bad words.
We're live right now.
Except for that guy. There's one guy on the edge. No, but now, like, Homeland is on, Justified. Yeah, you get the second season of, like, because the cable stuff kind of coming on.
Yeah, I see where you're going.
No, you don't.
Hey, do you still have commercials on ABC?
Commercials?
Yeah. you still have the commercials on ABC there.
Oh, advertisements.
Yeah, do you have those?
Yes.
Yeah, we still got them too. Here they come. We'll be right back. All right. Comedy Works. All Comedy right. Works in downtown Denver.
Huh?
We were just talking.
Where'd they come from?
Oh, hey. Whoa. They were enjoying the commercials.
Advertisements.
They were advertisements for boner pills. That's what's on at this time of night, you know.
Boner that pills? Kind of, oh, yeah. That's right.
Oh, yeah, like you never heard of them, Tim Allen.
This is a funny story. You'll be the judge. My family name, I hate even going there, but it's Dick, D-I-C-K. Less like it sounds, but it didn't always mean what you people think. It was
it's a Scottish name.
It is a Scottish name.
I know, I've heard of Dick.
This is how it starts. My mother was a Dick. My whole family are Dick. I've heard this. So we thought we were German. So I take my family to Germany to find the Dick, because it's Dick Knives or some companies in Germany.
You thought you were German?
Well, my uncle said...
Well, what happened? You kept annexing the neighbor's backyard or something?
However it worked out, it's some genealogist, that what they're called, they searched it out, and they went to Baltimore or someplace else, went to Germany. Right. And it turned out it was Dickman or Dixton. They changed their names. And somebody in the middle of all this from Munich goes, that's not German, that's Scottish. So we're all in, you know, Munich, so we had to eat sausage and go home.
Right.
It turns out it is a Scottish.
Yeah, no, it's a Scottish name. I was a lot.
Haggis.
Where I grew up.
Sure there were. You can't say it without this gag, but it is. We're Scottish.
No, that's the truth.
But I don't have that foolish accent. We dropped it years ago. It wasn't making us any money. It really wasn't. What the accent that's hip now is if you can get a Chinese accent, a little Chinese
don't,
accent.
Don't, man, don't. Please, no, please don't.
I don't have it. I just
okay,
don't have it.
Okay, because Margaret Cho's on next. You know what I'm saying? She is.
She is.
Yeah, but she's Korean, I think.
Wow, this is really going to go well, because do you know?
Well, I can't be sure. I'll ask her, though.
Well, now you have to ask her.
No, she's Korean.
She's Korean?
Yeah.
All right. Well, that's what did that have to do with the Chinese? How did that even go in your head?
I don't know.
Where did that even come from?
Crikey, man, come on.
So when that comes out, is there one of those little hazy things over your mouth?
Yeah. You know, when I realize this now, talking to you for a little while, I realize, you are. I got a map for sure.
See, I shouldn't have said it. The reason I said that is because I found out my family is Scottish.
It's a very common name in Scotland.
Dick?
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. No, it is.
How come no one ever told me this?
They didn't want to hurt your feelings, I guess. We're out of time.
I gotta go then.
Well, you want a coconut?
Yeah, okay. Why not?
Okay.
What the hell's the matter with
anyway, that's it.
There's actually stuff in there.
It's coconut milk.
Well, of course.
It's got a little comb over your coconut as well. Come on, everybody! Welcome back. My next guest is a very beautiful woman and a very funny comedian. She's performing in Asheville, North Carolina, January the 23rd. Please welcome the adorable Margaret Cho, everybody.
Hey,
Margaret, you look great. Is that Korean?
No. Actually, actually, well, you know, I'm Korean, but I found something out. This is a little bit like Tim. I did a television show where they searched my roots.
Right.
And all my life, I thought that I was Korean and had all this Korean pride. And they took my DNA, and you know what I found out? I'm Chinese. Like, I'm actually, like, the DNA that right. I gave was from China, and I was
had
so...
you, can you have DNA from another part of you that's completely Korean, or is it Chinese?
I think it's Chinese completely
well,
all
that's,
the way
that's,
through.
That's fine. That's,
it's fine, but yeah. It was, but, you know, when you think you're one thing, like, what if you found out that you were English? It's like that. It's serious. It's like, what the?
You really, that kind of messed with me a little bit there when you said that, yeah. That's impossible. Yeah. I couldn't be. No. We should do that. Let's do DNA testing.
You need to find out.
Right.
Because I just thought that I was Korean. You know, my parents are Korean. My grandparents are Korean. Like, who?
Well, that makes you pretty Korean at that point.
And then we all found out that we were Chinese. And so now we've just been Chinese for, like, the last 3 months.
How's it been? It's
all right.
Do you have to make any adjustments?
No, not really. I mean, I don't know. I mean, I just still don't know how to approach it because it's kind of like you. It's so late in life to
yeah, no, to find out you're a completely different nationality.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's tricky.
So, no.
So I don't know if I want to know then.
I know. Maybe it's better not to know.
Yeah, I don't know if I want to be English. I wouldn't mind being like, you know, Spanish or something like that.
Oh, that would be hot.
Yeah, that would be really hot. Hello, I don't always drink beer, but when I do. Yeah, that'd be good, but
that would be good, or German. I mean, I can't.
You do look quite German in this outfit. It's kind of Oktoberfest-y.
It is
sexy Oktoberfest.
Thank you. Well, I got it in Munich, and it is kind of going up my butt a little bit, but you know, it's fine. It's fine for right now.
I think it's meant to do that.
It's meant to kind of go up your butt.
Yeah, it's German.
Because the German people they'll stand up really straight, and I couldn't figure it out, and it's because their pants are going up their butt. It's a lederhosen.
Yeah. It's kind of like oh, my pants are going right up my ass. Things are moving. Do you know what I was always surprised about the Germans and the French? That I think that the stereotype, the ethnic stereotype is mixed up. Like, people think the French are all kind of, everything is so great, have fun, it's fine. But the French are like, and the Germans are actually, they're like, oh, this is so much fun, come on, everyone, pull your pants right up your bum.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Everybody. No, it's true. The Germans have this, like, great zest and appreciation for life.
Although they had a bit of a weird thing happen a few years ago, but other than that, they're,
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm.
They're very warm, and I was there for Christmas where they have the Krampus thing. You knew about, do they have that in Scotland?
What, Krampus?
Krampus.
Like Krampus and Krampus? You know,
no,
like, you know.
Krampus is Santa's evil helper. You know how, like, Santa has gifts and stuff, but Santa used to have
An evil henchman?
Yeah, he had a henchman that would, he had an enforcer.
What?
Who would come, and if you were naughty, there was consequences.
So say sometimes naughty children just have to deal with the consequences.
They have to deal with some consequences. So I went, and they had a big Krampus festival in Munich, and also I went to the capital of it, which is a place called Bad Gastein.
Ah,
in Austria.
Yeah, that sounds
Bad Gastein.
Yes, I see the joke possibilities.
Well, there were the possibilities. They didn't really understand why I kept thinking it was funny, and then I had drank a lot of sparkling water, and I was experiencing a lot of Bad Gastein. That was they really have a place called that, and there's Krampus there, and they're kind of like Chewbacca. They're Chewbacca adjacent. They're not actual Chewbacca. You know from Star Wars.
Yeah, I know Chewbacca from Star Wars. How did we get onto that? Suddenly we were in.
That's what a Krampus is. That's what it looks like.
Oh, Krampus looks like Chewbacca? All right.
Kind of. It's kind of like a Chewbacca, kind of like, you know, a Bigfoot.
I've never seen a Bigfoot. Oh. And neither have you, Margaret Cho. Neither have you. Have you?
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
Do you still go to Scotland? You used to go to Scotland a lot.
I go to Scotland a lot. I think Scotland is really beautiful, and I've been doing, like, shows there, and it's, to me, a very exotic.
They love you there in Scotland.
They are wonderful. Well, England is great, but, you know, it's hard, too. Like, they don't like you at first. I felt bad. Like, when I first started going there, they didn't know who I was, and then I was trying to do
shows.
Try
being born there. Oh, yeah.
You try to do shows. And they expect a lot, and, you know, they see an Asian woman on stage and they start booing right away, and I'm like, what, are you still mad that I broke up the Beatles? And they're like, you know.
Right, yeah, yeah.
And now they love
it. No, come on, it's time we go over that. It's time we go over it. That's funny.
It's wonderful.
Do you have a nice time there?
I do. I have a really good time.
It's lovely over there. I've grown very fond of it recently.
Very cold. You have a place there now, don't you?
Yeah, I have a house in Scotland. Yeah. Where my family live and I came from to come here.
Yeah. But then you never, did you ever like, did you stay there? You went to London and then came here from...
I went to London and then came to America. I went to London and went, I tested my DNA, decided that I wasn't English, and I...
realized.
Yeah.
Well, we're glad to have you here.
Well, thanks very much. It's nice to be here. Hey, want to have a quiet moment?
Okay.
Okay. Moments. It gets a little weird, but very addictive, the quiet moment. Have you noticed?
It's emotional. It's like, you know, and then you connect with, you know, different
things.
And you lock eyes with different eyes. Well,
there's a little sexual tension going on here.
Yeah,
what the hell?
I mean, you think he really likes me. I don't know. I'm not sure, but I don't want to assume anything.
Jeff?
Those lederhosen are turning me on.
You know, they really are.
Would you like to see my Krampus?
Isn't he adorable?
He's so adorable.
He's adorable, he is. So, listen, you're out doing the stand-up then, Asheville, you say?
Yes, Asheville and I'm on tour.
Oh, really? You got a tour bus?
Yeah. Oh, no, yeah. I don't have a tour bus. It's just me. So
just going
I would have to drive it.
No, you don't want to do that.
No, I don't want to do that. And I, you know, it's a driving. I'm a little bit like I almost never drive anymore. And then I got it, and I got in a motorcycle accident since the last time I saw you.
Really? Are you all right?
Yeah. Well, no, I crashed my bike.
Yes, so that's what an accident is. But are you all right?
I was super into it. And I remember you said to me when I was here before that I would be like, you love your bike until you have your accident, mm-hmm. And I hadn't had it, and then I had it.
How'd you feel about the bike?
Well, I was scared. I was going up a hill, and then I wasn't going fast enough, and then the bike just rolled over and went on top of me, and I was just laying under it for a long time.
That's an unusual one. I haven't heard of that one before.
I was laying under it for a really long time until the postman came. There was a postman that they stopped, and he was like, he stopped his truck and then came out and like lifted the bike off me and then went
God
back
bless
to
the U.S.
mail
service. They're always there when you need them.
He was really great.
Yeah.
But then I didn't want to get back on it because I went back home, and I had gray hair from it because I was so scared.
Yeah, no, it's frightening. It's frightening when you get when you have an accident and something like that. I busted 3 ribs, my collarbone. It's horrible.
It's horrible. But they're so cool.
They look cool until they're lying on top of you.
And then you're laying there underneath it.
Yeah. We're out of time, Margaret.
Oh, no.
Yeah. No, not in life. Just
for now. Okay.
Yeah. Margaret Cho, everybody.
What did we learn on the show tonight,
Greg? Good night, everybody. Good night, guys.